All right, guys, let's get fired up and make some flaming hot fonts. All right, so the first thing we have to do is open up Autodesk Sketchbook. Now click on the square in the top left-hand corner, and then you're gonna click on New Sketch. And scroll down to where it says Custom, click on that, and then pull that bar all the way over to the right-hand side, and then click the check mark. Now go down to the right-hand corner where it says Background. Then we're going to choose the color black. Now click this plus button to add a new layer. Click the T on the top toolbar. And where it says text, you're going to type in your name. Now I'm going to type in Art to make mine, but you're going to put in either your first or your last name. Now click on the color wheel to the right of that. And you're going to choose a warmish yellowy orange kind of color. Then click Done. With two fingers, you can start to rotate your canvas to make it horizontal. Then click the arrows at the top, enlarge your font with two fingers, and rotate it to the bottom center of your canvas. On the left side, you're going to select the technical pen and make sure the size is at 20 and the opacity is at 100%. Next, click on the circle on the top of the toolbar on the right, then click the little eyedropper tool. Now this will give us crosshairs that you're going to line up over that yellow color that we put in our name, or in this case my word art. Then we're going to go back, make sure our technical pen is highlighted, and you are going to zoom in a little bit and start drawing flames over your letters. Now these flames are only going to be coming off the top of my letters. So I'm going to start by making these flames bigger at the bottom and thinner as they go up to the top. And again, I'm only putting them on the top of the letters. I find it helpful to look up pictures online of fire or flames. That way I have an idea of what I should be drawing and what it should look like. This is called a reference photo, and it's really important that artists use them whenever they're drawing. So pictures like this one or this one or this one would all be helpful. Whew, all right, got that one done. Now we're going to use the fill bucket, and that's on the top bar. We're going to slide this little bar over all the way to the right, and now we can fill in all those black areas in our flames. Don't forget that you can also use two fingers to zoom in to fill in all those hard to reach little spaces. And oh my gosh, I missed the flame. Nobody saw that. Because I hit the undo button at the top. Remember, you can always do that if you need to go back and fix anything. All right, it looks like I have all of those little spaces filled in. Now I can go back up to the top and click the paint bucket tool again to get rid of that. Then I'm going to go back over to that circle on the side, and I'm going to choose a yellowish orange color. And this one's going to be more of an orange than yellow. And I'm just going to trace around the top of my flames that I did on top of my letters. So I'm just going to be carefully going around these. And I'm just outlining them all in this orangey yellow color. Whew. Once that is done, we're going to do the same thing again, but with red. So go back to the color circle, change it to red, and let's go around all those orange lines with red. Perfect. Now go over to the toolbar on the left, and we're going to use the Smudge Web Brush, and it looks like this. Now if you can't find it, go to the library by clicking on the top bar. You'll find it under the Smudge Tools, and then you can drag and drop it right into your toolbar on the left. Perfect. Now you just need one more tool. Make sure you have the hard airbrush tool on your toolbar. The size should be 100.7 and the opacity should be at 100%. The last customization that you need to do is go to brush types, and on the side you're going to scroll down and change that to color. Now that it says color across from your brush types, you're going to take the airbrush and go around all the outline edges of your flames. Once you have that done, you're going to click on that Smudge Web Brush. You're going to make sure that the size is 57.4 or about that. The flow is about 16% and the strength is about 21%. Now, take that brush and start inside the yellow and work your way up and kind of wiggle it a little bit as it comes out, so it has a wispy look to it, so it starts to look like flames. This can take a little bit of practice, so take your time, but make sure that you always start off in the yellow areas and pull your way up to the top, kind of wiggle it up, kind of feel the flow of that flame as it goes up. Yes, that looks great. Now let's save your masterpiece. Click on the square on the left of the top bar. Click Share. Click Others. And click Gmail. Now you can type in your email that you want to send it to. Then press the triangle in the upper right hand corner. And you're done. Don't forget to also save your work on the tablet. Click on the square in the top left. Click Share. Click Save to Device. Now you can rename it and click the blue check mark when you're done. Congratulations! I am so proud of you. Keep being amazing.